Over in the U.S., a motive has yet to be found for the tragic shooting at the Michigan State University that left three students dead and five others in critical condition. Authorities say they recovered a handgun and searched a residence linked to the suspect. Law enforcement also investigating a note found on the suspect, who was recovered dead from a self-inflicted gunshot wound outside the campus hours after a shooting rampage. President Joe Biden joining calls to stop gun violence as a Midwestern U.S. state marks its second school shooting in 15 months.
We're all broken by an all too familiar feeling. Another place that is supposed to be about community and togetherness, shattered by bullets and bloodshed. We know this is a uniquely American problem. We cannot keep living like this.
North Vancouver is holding prayer services for a Filipino community leader's husband and daughter. Both died in a fire at their home last week. Rowena Papasin tells us more.
A daily novena is being offered at St. Paul's Church, one of the oldest churches in Vancouver, for Robert and Gail Fernley, the father and daughter who died in the early morning fire last Thursday, February 9, at their residence in North Vancouver. Robert, or Bob, as he is known to family and friends, a former councillor in the city of North Vancouver, is the husband of Filipino-Canadian community leader Via Fernley. Their eldest son, also named Bob, said his younger brother, Paolo, saw the fire and tried to wake everyone up.
My dad has a heart condition, and he was trying to follow my brother, but at a certain point, he just fell away, and the door closed. My sister, he was calling for her around the side of the house. He was calling her name, but my sister had a cat, and probably, she was trying to, save her cat.
Via, with her son Paolo, were able to escape the blaze and were immediately taken to the hospital. They were later released and are now temporarily staying at a hotel. Bob said his brother was a hero for trying to save everyone.
I heard that some of the police officers and the firefighters, they were reduced to tears because of how hard he tried, And he was covered in blood, they said. He hurt himself pretty well trying to help them. But what he did, he's a hero.
Via remembered her husband, Rob, and her daughter, Gail.
No, I'm just overwhelmed. My Gail, that photo over there exemplifies, the way they're happy. And that's kind-hearted, my daughter. Always wants the best for other people. Witty, yeah. And my husband, of course, I remember most about him. There's really, as I said, not one word, just a lot. Just he's a big person, and yeah, he loves life.
North Vancouver Mayor Linda Buchanan came to the novena to offer her support to the family and pay her respects to Bob, who served for four terms as a councillor in North Vancouver. The news of the fire shocked friends of the Fernley family.
Nashock ako talaga. Tapos nung sabihin nila na sabi daw ni Via na Bob and Gail is gone. So sabi ko naman, what do they mean he's gone? Sabi ko naman, so wala na.
Following the tragic incident, various groups within the community have rallied to help Via and her two sons.
There's several communities organizing to help her, especially that she lost her family and at the same time all her belongings.
She got nothing. Damit lang yan dala niya, right? I think she needs some monetary support.
Cepedeo added that those who want to help can reach her on her cell phone. There's also a GoFundMe page created to help Via and her sons, which has already exceeded the target of $10,000. Bob said he is grateful for the community's support. As Via tries to make sense of what happened to her husband and daughter, she urges everyone to show their family their love every day.
Spend the day with your loved ones as if it is the last day you have with them. Yeah, those are very precious moments. Each day is a precious moment you spend with your family, really.
Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, North Vancouver.